two resistances are connected in series only if and only if they are connected only at a particular point. R1, this resistance R1, and R2 are connected in series. Now the question is that what will happen if a third resistor R3 is added to these two resistors R1 and R2? See, we are adding third resistor R3. Are they in series? No, they are not in series. R1 and R2, here R1 and R2 are in series because no third resistor is there. But here R1 and R2 are not in series because a third resistor R3 is added to it. You can understand this way that current through R1 is flowing, the same current is flowing through R2. But in this case, current through R1, same current is not flowing through R2, but it is growing branches over here. Okay, so we can say that R1, R2 and R3 are not in series. They are not in series. Parallel resistance. Now, when can two resistors be said to be connected in parallel? Two resistors are said to be connected in parallel when they are connected across each other. See, they are connected at two points. Now, what can you say about this particular case? R1, R2, R3, R4. Are they in parallel? No, they are not in parallel. Now, in case of parallel resistances, voltage across R1 will be voltage across R2. Here we are not talking about the voltages, but still I am telling you that voltage across R1 will be voltage across R2. But in this case, we cannot say like that. So it is easy to remember when the resistances are parallel and when they are not in parallel. Now coming back to this, we'll go through one simple sum. This, find the equivalent resistance between the A and B. Now first, let me tell you what is this A and B. A and B are the nodes. What is a node? Nodes are points where minimum two wires meet. More than two wires meeting is possible, but nodes are the points where minimum two wires meet. See, this wire and this wire. Okay, so before we move on to the solution, we'll look at the circuit, this circuit diagram carefully. I'm redrawing it, and see this yellow highlighted portion. I have added this, see this yellow highlighted portion. These yellow highlighted portion are the short circuited branches. What is meant by short circuited branches? Observe that there is no resistor in this branch. No resistor is connected between these two branches. So these are called as short circuited branches. Short form, you can sometimes they use SC branches. Okay. After we move on, we can see that here there are two wires meet. No name is given over here. So I am giving this name as C. This is node C and this is node D. Having said this, I am telling you that node A and D, this is the node A, this is the node D. Node A and D can be shorted. What do you mean by they can be shorted? Node A and D can be shorted implies that they can be treated as one node. They can be treated, I repeat, node A and D can be shorted implies that they can be treated as one node. Again, here you can see that node C and node B can be shorted. That means node C and node B can be treated as one node. Let's see what happens if you treat them as one node. Okay. In the next circuit diagram, in this circuit diagram, what I am doing, A and D I have treated as one node. Putting here A and D. This is node A and D. And this is node C and B. Now how do I get this figure? I'll draw it again for you. See. First I will write node A and D. A and D point, no point or node, node A and D can be shorted together. So I'm giving it as one point. So I'm using this node A comma D. Okay. Writing this as node A comma D, because I told you, or reason I already told you, Now, the reason I told you that nodes which are shorted together can be treated as single points. So I am writing it as this way as A comma D, and this as C comma D. Another note, this A and D are shorted, C and B are shorted together. Now, what all resistances come between A and C, A and B, D and C will be in between these two nodes. I'm again and again repeating, what all resistances that come between A and C or A and B or D and C or D and B will come in between these two points. How? Let's see. First of all, we move on to this branch. Here, this 10 ohm resistance between A and C. So, what we do? We connect a 10 ohm resistance over here. 10 ohm resistance. Okay. Next, we see this 10 ohm resistance, where it goes? Between C and D. This is D, this is C. Another 10 ohm resistance can be connected between D and C. Like that. Next, between resistance between D and B, that is this 10 ohm resistance, another 10 ohm resistance connected between D and B. Okay, so far so good. Again, we can write it as bring out these nodes as A and B. So, we get this kind of a circuit diagram. Now, having said this, what I will do is, what can you say about the series and parallel resistances about this? What can you say about these three resistors, these three 10 ohm resistors? Yes. These three resistors can be very well said to be in parallel. These three resistances are very well said to be in parallel because they are connected across each other. So, we can simply write RAB is equal to 10 ohm in parallel with 10 ohm in parallel with 10 ohm. Okay, 1 by RAB is equal to 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10 plus 1 by 10. Now, you can simply write the x inverse function, use the x inverse function if you are using Calci FX991ES, simply use the x inverse function and then again inverse, you will get its value as 3.33 ohms RAB. Okay. And we'll see, this is the value of this resistance. We'll see another example. In this case, we can find the equivalent resistances. Another problem is find the equivalent resistances between A and B. Now, here you can see that this diagram A and B, this looks quite complicated. But again, we are using our own method technique. We found out the short circuited branch. This one is the short circuited branch. This another is the short circuited branch. I am redrawing this diagram, naming the unnamed nodes and naming the short circuited branches. You will observe that I have renamed this C node and I have renamed this E node, F node and D node, which I have named it, which they have not provided in the problem. Observe the short that I have, that C, E and F are short circuited branches. C and D are short circuited nodes. Node C and D are short circuited. Node E and F are short circuited. That means they can be treated as one node. What will you do after this? Again, if we short circuit it, we again get a very simple small diagram like this. Again, I will show you how this diagram came into picture. See, what I am doing, I am writing here this C node, C and D, which are short circuited branches. This C and D short circuited branches. Fine. Then here another short circuited branch, which can be treated as one node, are E and F. E and F. Okay. Now, we go this way. the resistance between B and C. And there is one more thing, B and A are also there. One minute, I'm changing the color. C and D and E and F. I'm drawing the figures in black color so that people can see it very clearly. So C and D, this C and D, again I'm drawing it, and E and F. Okay, next, there is one more thing. They have taken out two nodes A and B across which we have to find out the resistance B and A. So far I have not put any resistances. Between B and C there is a resistance of 2 ohms. How will I represent it? How will I represent it? 2 ohms here. Between A and this resistance, 8 ohm resistance I am talking about. 2 ohm resistance we have finished. 8 ohm resistance is between A and E. 8 ohm, and here this is 2 ohm. Now again, all resistances going from there, we'll name it between C and F. This resistance between C and F, you can see two resistances, 15 ohm and 10 ohm. So between C and F, again we'll do the same thing. We can see two resistances. So we'll draw your two resistances. One is of 15 ohm, one is of 10 ohm. Again, between F and D, between this F and D, there are two resistances. This is F and this is D over here. Two resistances, 10 ohm, 40 ohm. 10 ohm and 40 ohm. Just drawing it correctly, 10 ohm. Now, there is third branch between D and E. This is D and this is E. Two resistances are there. This is 20 ohm and 30 ohm. Okay. Now, simplifying this figure, we get this figure. If you draw it in a proper way, we get this kind of a figure, this kind of a diagram. I'll see what happens next. We'll get the, can you tell me which branches are in parallel or series over here? Again, what I have done, I have marked three branches, branch A, branch B and branch C. This is branch A, branch B and branch C. I am observing that 15 ohm and 10 ohm are in series. 10 ohm, 40 ohm are in series, 20 ohm, 30 ohm are in series. So we'll very soon write the series equations for every branch. For branch A, RA is equal to 15 plus 10 is equal to 25 ohms. Branch B, RB is equal to 10 plus 40, that is 50 ohms. Branch C, RC is equal to 20 ohm plus 30 is equal to 50 ohms. Branch A is this, branch B is this, and branch C is this. Next, we observe that after we get the summation of these three, A in the branch, in the three branches A, B and C, we observe that are these resistances in series or in parallel? I can say that A branches A, B and C are in parallel. So what I do, I take the 1 by R P is equal to, just a representation for all these branches, say I call it RP. RP is equal to 1 by 25 plus 1 by